Next up is Filipp Romanov. So, Filipp, I'm going to give you a couple moments to get ready. And Filipp will be discussing discoveries of variable stars by amateur astronomers using data mining on the example of eclipsing binary Romanov V20.
My name is Filipp Romanov, and title of my presentation is Discoveries of Variable Stars by Amateur Astronomers Using Data Mining on the example of Eclipsing Binary Romanov V20. The background of the first slide is a photo of the night sky over the Sea of Japan and the lighthouse. I took this photo in my small homeland near Yuzhno-Morskoy, Primorsky Krai, Russia. Second slide, about me. I'm 23 years old. I have been an amateur astronomer for over 11 years based on self-education. I am a member of the AAVSO. I want and I plan to go to university to study astronomy. The first variable star discovered by me was registered in the International Variable Star Index almost 5 years ago. I found its variability using the data mining in the photometric data of the Northern Sky Variability Survey. Besides 71 variable stars, I am the discoverer of planetary nebulae candidates, astronomical transients, and possible double stars. Third slide. These are the types of variable stars discovered by me. At first, I searched for only semi-regular variable stars, but when I gained experience, I began to find variables of other types, including eclipsing variables and cataclysmic. Some of them I discovered by the method of blinking digitized photographic plates, but most I discovered by the method of data mining. On the example of an eclipsing variable of the algo type Romanov V20, I will tell you how to search for variable stars with this method. On the fourth slide, you can see information about this variable star. This was registered in the VSX under the name of Romanov V20. Romanov is my last name, V is an abbreviation for the word variable. 20 is the ordinal number of stars in the V6 with this designation. The star is located in the southern celestial hemisphere. The fifth slide shows the data of the star from the Vizier catalogs and from the AAVSO Photometric or Sky Survey APAS. As you can see, the star outside of eclipses is bright enough to be photographed with amateur telescopes. Estimated distance to the star is 6,034 light years. Next slide. How I choose this star from many others to search for variability, I used TAP Vizier service. I wrote the code in the astronomical data query language. You can see it in the screenshot, in which I requested data from the always catalog from a specific area of the sky and with certain colors and magnitudes of the stars. In order to exclude possible Mira type variables from the search results. On the next slide, you can see the search results. I select the stars with values in the VAR column with 9 and 9 in the first two of four bands. VAR is variability flag in the WISE source records. It shows a measure of probability that the SAS is variable in that band. I choose the highest values and copy the coordinates of those stars. But this does not mean for sure that they are real variables. If they were not published in the catalogs of variable stars, this must be checked manually. The next slide show a screenshot of the Vizier service. It is necessary to check by the coordinates of the selected stars whether their variability was known earlier in different astronomical catalogs. It also needs to check it in the SIMBAD service. This is not much different. After checking one of the stars for the absence of the previously known variability at the given coordinates, I requested photometric data from the Sky Survey ASASSN. On the 10th slide you can see the light curve of the selected star from the data of this survey, which were opened in the VSTAR software. It is immediately clear here that is an eclipsing variable. This slide shows how I was looking for a period in the software VSTAR. First, I found an approximate period in days and then improved it according to the shape of the phase plot. At first I checked a range from 0 to 10 days when searching for a period, and at the end I already checked periods from 1 to 2 days. As you can see, a very clear period has been found. The next slide shows the phase plot for the selected period and for a specific epoch. From this data, I determined the amplitude of the eclipses and the duration of the primary eclipse. As you can see from the light curve, this is a large amplitude eclipsing variable. During the primary eclipse, the magnitude decreases by almost 3 units. Next, I checked the photometric data for the star from other sky surveys. Part of all primary eclipse duration was recorded in the SuperWASP data. In the ASAS3 data, the eclipse is clearly visible as a gap in the phase plot. In the FS epoch photometry data, the eclipse was recorded in different bands. Finally, in the data of nearby air, both eclipses were recorded very well. In the phase plot, you can see different duration of the eclipses and amplitude ratio because of infrared bands. To register a variable star in the AAVSO VSX, discoverer must have an account. This is a difference from the account of the main AAVSO website. In the form of submit of a new variable star, it is necessary to fill in the fields with the information, data from catalogs, the found values of the period, amplitude and duration of the eclipse, phase plot and the source of information. If discoverer had incorrect data, then the VSX administration will inform discoverer about this for correction, and when everything is correct, the star will be registered. Next, it need to get a star chart with the variable star plotter using AAVSO unique identifier of variable star. If there are no comparison reference stars, then it need request them from the AAVSO. After adding the comparison stars, I observed the primary eclipse of the star using a remote telescope of iTelescope Net in Australia. I calculated the time of minima using the ephemeris of the page in the VSX, but weather conditions and other circumstances allowed me to record only part of all primary eclipse duration. For photometric measures, I used Maxim DL Pro version 6.23 demo software and AAVSO star chart. In the end, I combined the data from several sky surveys with my photometric observations, and I improved the data on amplitudes of eclipses, the epoch, period and duration of primary eclipse. On this slide I wrote sources of information, references. On this slide you can see my contacts. This is my first experience of speaking in English. I had no practice in spoken English, so I'm ready to answer your questions only in writing. At the end of my presentation, on the last slide, thank you for your attention, there is my landscape photo on the coast of the Sea of Japan, a star sea. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Filipp. That was wonderful. We don't have questions for you right now, but I do have some comments for you from people. Bob Buckheim says, Filipp, this is a wonderful project. Congratulations. And Sebastian Otero, who you know from BSX, says, Filipp, congratulations for your impressive work. We'll be waiting for Romanov V100. Your findings show that large amplitude variables can still be discovered by amateur observers using publicly available data. And I'd like to add my own congratulations to you as well. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Filipp. So